An urgent humanitarian crisis continues on our southern border, leaving tens of thousands of immigrant children in limbo. In the Southwest, it's a crush of emotions, from anger to exacerbation. While in Washington, it's the usual finger-pointing and chest-thumping. Reform, security, compromise, so many choices. I'm Michael Smerconish. Let's get started. My first headline is from the New York Times, and it reads, "Immigrant surge rooted in law to curb child trafficking." Some of the blame for the current immigration crisis is being given to a 2008 human trafficking law. It gave greater protections to unaccompanied children coming into this country from non-contiguous nations. So, is the needed fix as simple as amending that law? My next guest is Nebraska Republican Congressman Jeff Fortenberry, who was a chief backer of that legislation. Congressman, children from Central America are treated differently than those from Mexico. Why? What was the logic of the law?
Well, first of all, I was very proud to be a part of the sponsoring of the victims' rights. Human trafficking is a modern form of slavery. It is a scourge for humanity, and America must project its values and protect vulnerable persons. So I was very proud to be a part of this 2008 law. This problem with a surge of children and families at the border did not occur until 2013. Did not occur in 08, 09, 10, or 11. 5 years this. The reality is this is a convergence of factors of desperate poverty, ungoverned space, as well as an exploitation of our laws. And the president fostered an environment in which, in 2012, he suggested that deportations were going to decrease. And I think that was a corollary to exploitation of this law and other factors that have led to this sad, sad, tragic situation along the border. Let me add this as well, if I could. I just think it's unconscionable that the president would go to Texas for a fundraiser and a photo op, but not visit our border. Communities are suffering, children are suffering, and our immigration policy appears in disarray. He should be in the White House right now preparing a speech to the nation as to how we are going to get this back under control.
I respect all of that. It doesn't answer my question. I really started with the simple premise of what was the logic of treating kids from Mexico different from kids from Central America. Could you answer that?
It's my understanding that buried within the 08 law, there is a provision that allows the president to negotiate with the Central American countries repatriation agreements, and that hasn't happened. There may be a need to actually fix that portion of the law so that that aspect of the dynamic which has fostered the conditions for the surge of children can stop. But the first thing that needs to happen is some leadership. If I would suggest to the president that he send National Guard troops to the border to help back up the border control and get the situation under control, continue to suggest and say clearly that any person arriving here illegal will be sent home quickly. And third is to work and demand from the governments of Guatemala, Honduras, as well as El Salvador, that they create the safe conditions for repatriation of children and families so that they are humanely treated. That would create the conditions by which we can maybe fix portions of the earlier law that are being exploited, restore order, and then deal with the necessary exceptions for those who have just reasons to seek asylum.
Allow me to show to you what conservative syndicated columnist Charles Krauthammer published yesterday in the Washington Post and indeed around the nation. What he said was, stopping this wave is not complicated. A serious president would go to Congress tomorrow proposing a change in the law simply mandating that Central American kids get the same treatment as Mexican kids and be subject to immediate repatriation. Is it that simple?
What I've suggested to you is the president fostered the conditions for the arrival, this surge of children along the border. That didn't happen until 2013. In 2012, the president sent a clear message that he was going to decrease the number of deportations, and that fostered the conditions, along with the desperate poverty, the violence, and the ungoverned space.
Here's where I'm coming from. Respectfully, you've got colleagues like Jeff Flake and John McCain, two Republican senators who are introducing legislation to change a law that for which you were the chief backer. You've got Henry Cuellar, a Democrat in the House, John Cornyn, a Republican in the Senate, who are saying the same thing, that this law in 2008 brought about unintended unintended consequences when you began treating Central American kids different from Mexican kids. And they all seem to be saying, and so does Charles Krauthammer, the first thing we got to do is change that law.
First of all, you're setting me up in some sort of odd opposition to the necessary changes of laws that have been a factor. And I'm just telling you that it's more complicated than that. It's a convergence of factors, and it would be helpful if the president showed some responsibility as well here. He, in 2012, suggested that deportations were going to decline. We did not have this problem in 09, 10, 11, and 12, 5 years after the law. If we need to make necessary changes, that's fine. But it's my understanding there is a provision already in that law. Allow the president to negotiate repatriation agreements with Honduras, El Salvador, and Guatemala. Look, the First Lady of Honduras said, we want our children back. And we agree with that. And at the same time, we have to get order restored to the border, as well as treat children humanely. But if we don't do all of these things quickly, there will be additional surges of children who are being exploited, who are victims of trafficking, which is, by the way, the reason that this law was set up in the first place. America must lead with her values, and human trafficking is a form of modern slavery, and it's simply wrong, especially to children.
The president has asked Congress for $3.7 billion so that there can be more immigration judges and that we can help these Central American nations repatriate these kids. Are you supportive of that?
I serve on the Appropriations Committee. This is something that's completely overlooked by the media. Last week, we dealt with what's called a Foreign Operations Subcommittee Appropriations Bill. We already appropriated money to try to stop the flow of families and children from these Central American countries and set up the repatriation processes by which children and families will be humanely treated. But it would be helpful if the president also demanded that those governments get into action right now. That might be something that Congress comes together around, as well as additional border security. But we're not going to simply give a blank check. We have to go through this methodologically in a sound way to restore order in a situation that's chaotic. If you don't do that, you're undermining America's ability to be generous to those who are in need. America's a hallmark of immigration policy has been to open ourselves to people who want to come here, who are fleeing economic hardship or political persecution and build better lives. But if you don't have an orderly and just immigration system, you undermine the ability of the country to do that generously, and it's not fair to those who are already following the law.
I was listening to your critique very carefully of the White House and the role that you think that the president played in creating this, which is why I brought up the $3.7 billion request that he's made, because from the sidelines,
yes,
sir, it seems like he's offering to the Congress exactly that which a moment ago you told me is necessary. And so then I say to you, well, are you supportive of this? And the answer seems to be no.
The president has asked for a very big, large expenditure. It's the responsibility of Congress to go through that line by line, but it's also the responsibility of the president to propose policy changes and to take some responsibility for this. I didn't say created. I said he fostered the environment by suggesting that deportations were going to decrease. 5 years after the law that you're suggesting is the main corollary here for the surge of children. So there needs to be some responsibility taken. I imagine Congress will be very intent on helping with increased border security.
It's not me as some pundit saying it. I mean, you've got Jeff Flake and John McCain, two Republicans in the Senate, who are saying the first thing we ought to do is change that law. I'm simply trying to get to the bottom of it. You can have the final word, and thanks so much for being here. Go ahead.
I think the first thing that we ought to do, or the president ought to do, as I said earlier, is call the National Guard to the border to assist border control in getting the situation back under control. Secondly, clearly send the message that each person who arrives here illegally is going to be sent back quickly. And third, demand that those governments in Central America work with us for the proper repatriation of children and families. Then we've got a framework for order here. We can deal with tweaks or adjustments to prior laws, but we've got a framework for order, and then we can address people who have legitimate needs, just needs for asylum in our country. That's
all
the
right
way to get this situation back under control. Thank you.
Congressman Jeff Fortenberry, thank you, sir, for being here. You remember that old headline, the one that said, immigrant surge rooted in law?